Okay, guys, we're ready. One more time, a round of applause for the class of 2022. Okay, can we take our seats for the moment? There's going to be plenty of photos tonight, don't worry. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. Graduation ceremony for the class of 2022. We are here today to celebrate the incredible accomplishments that our seniors have made over their time at GAAQ. Students, I know you and your parents have been eagerly awaiting this day. I could not be more proud to be here today to celebrate the end of this chapter with you and your families. Unfortunately, there is one special person who is not here with us tonight. I know that Ms. Tonda would not want me to take anything away from this celebration, but before we begin our speeches and congratulatory remarks, I would like to have a moment's silence to remember the lasting impression that Ms. Tonda has left on our community. She will be missed by us all. And now invite Ibrahim to recite a passage from the Holy Quran. Please, a gentle reminder not to applaud after the reciting.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وإن يكذبوك فقد كذب الذين من قبلهم جاءتهم رسلهم بالبينات وبالزبر وبالكتاب المنير ثم أخذت الذين كفروا فكيف كان نكير ألم تر أن الله أنزل من السماء ماء فأخرجنا به ثمرات مختلفا ألوانها ومن الجبال جدد بيض وحمر مختلف ألوانها وغرابيب سود ومن الناس والدواب والأنعام مختلف ألوانه كذلك إنما يخشى الله من عباده العلماء إن الله عزيز غفور إن الذين يتلون كتاب الله وأقاموا الصلاة وأنفقوا مما رزقناهم سرا وعلانية يرجون تجارة لن تبور ليوفيهم أجورهم ويزيدهم من فضله إنه غفور شكور صدق الله العظيم.
May we all stand for the playing of the national anthem. Thank you. My boss, I would like to welcome Mr. Mark Lentz, head of school, to the podium.
Shorter than Eamon. First and foremost, I would like to thank our parents and our guests to our first graduation in over 3 years. I hope it lives up to your very well-deserved expectations. And if you will, I have talked to your children often recently about trust, about the fact that this day is more for you than it is for them. I have warned them that they have no idea what is ahead of them, and a few of them have heard me talk about fledglings. So if you will, this will be less of a graduation speech and more of a graduation explanation. A graduation is a rite of passage. A rite of passage is a traditional ceremony that most societies have that recognizes that someone has transferred from their childhood stage to their adult stage. In many countries all over the world, a high school graduation is symbolic of the fact that they are about to leave, go on to college, they are no longer children, and they have become adults. Raptors are birds. Our mascot is the raptors. Birds fledge. Fledging is when a bird changes from a child to an adult. It's a very dramatic event for a raptor. At some point, baby raptors hatch in eggs, they grow up in nests where mommy and daddy birds take care of them. And at some point, that young raptor decides it's ready to leave the nest, and it jumps out. For the vast majority of raptors, they fly successfully, they flap their wings, and they fly away and become adult birds and do not return to the nest. For the rare few that do not fly, they generally do not make it. Luckily, we are not birds. We are humans. The fledging process for us is a much longer and slower process for your parents. So when I talk about trust, they have been watching you fledge for all intents and purposes from that first day, and they will remember because they are watching you now and they were watching you then. That first day you stood up and walked away. And I would guess that many of you were doing that as you tried to make sure they did not fall down. And you have probably spent the last 17 or 18 years continuing to do that as they continue to fledge. And there are many examples. You will not remember the first time you said mom or dad, but I promise you, they remember the first time you said mom or dad. They were watching you. There are many examples of things that you did that were fledging. The first time you rode a bike, the first time you dove in the pool and swam on your own, they were watching. And much like those precocious raptors that think they're ready to leave the nest, you have probably always thought you knew what you were doing. But it was the first time you've ever done it, and they were watching you, and they were trusting that they'd prepared you, and they were probably really nervous. So if you allow me a very silly story from my own childhood, and I will talk about my own son, who is now 9, who is absolutely convinced that he is ready to stay home alone on his own. He no longer needs mommy and daddy to watch him, and he doesn't need his big sister. He knows he is ready. And I'm sure in his brain, he thinks he's going to be watching TV, playing on the PS4, doing roadblocks on the iPad while eating popcorn, and it's gonna just be a party. He thinks he knows what he has ahead of him. He has no idea because he has never done it. Much like a much younger Mr. Lentz many, many years ago, who somehow convinced his parents that he was ready to stay home when they were going grocery shopping. I knew I was ready at that moment, and somehow I convinced them to trust me. But I could see the look in their eyes, and they were right, and I was wrong. I did not successfully fledge that day, because sometime 15 or 20 minutes after they left, I heard noises in the house and was convinced that the scary monsters that live in various places were out to get me, and I fled the house in abject terror, ran down to the end of the driveway, and sat beside the mailbox waiting for my mom and dad to get home from the grocery store. It was many years before they trusted me to stay home alone again. So, I talked about trust. I do trust you guys. I have said that you don't know what's ahead of you, but have you ever heard me say that you're not prepared. I trust that you are prepared. I trust that your parents have prepared you. I hope and trust that we have prepared you. We came up with these raptor values of purpose, leadership, innovation, respect, and tenacity. We came up with those together as a group many years ago because as a group we decided that's what your children need to stop being children and start being successful adults. I absolutely trust you have learned those values. I trust that you are ready to fledge. I trust you will soar away successfully when you leave the nest. I only ask that you're never afraid to fly back. And I would like to take this opportunity to say to the graduating class of 2022 one last time, go Raptors.
I've lost where I am on the script. Hold on. Happens. Please welcome Miss LaRue, who will be giving a speech.
Good evening. Many of the graduates tonight have known me since I was Miss Wilmot. Quite a lot has changed since then. My four-year-old daughter, Lily, really loves story time. So I thought it would be nice to read you a story, hopefully not put you to sleep. While the metaphor is about a sculptor and his apprentice, it really is all about trying, giving your all, and no matter how many failures you have along the way, you'll still be able to go forward if you just keep trying. How do you do that? I didn't realize I had said it out loud, but the sculptor looked over and replied, "You simply do it." "Oh no, I could never do that." "How do you know?" he asked. "I just know." Confused, I walked away. He must be joking, I thought. But as I left, I couldn't help wondering what it would be like to create something so incredible. When I returned, the sculptor looked over at me and asked, "How is your sculpture coming along?" "I'm just here to watch." "The best way to give your talents an opportunity is to try," he responded. "I'd rather just watch. I can't mess things up if I just watch." "Ah, yes," he nodded. "If you do nothing, it feels safe, but everything stays the same. If you do nothing, there is less to experience, less to love, less to learn. The fear of failing is the scariest part, and it stops most people from starting. The only way to get to where you want to go is to take a step in that direction. And the best way to do that is to begin." It was all I could think about. Even as I slept, I dreamt of creating beautiful things. I was excited to get started, but as I was working, I realized that something was wrong. With every strike, I felt a little more deflated. With every blow, my disappointment grew. This was not turning out the way I had imagined. Why did I think I could do it? Why had I let myself care about this so much? The next time I saw the sculptor, he asked me about my work. I told him I was no good and I had quit. "Why would you do that?" he asked. "Because it feels awful to want something so badly and then just be disappointed." "Yes," the sculptor replied. "Disappointment hurts, but failure is temporary, and in many ways necessary. It allows us to, it shows us how something can't be done, which means we're a little bit closer to finding out how it can. When you first tried to walk, you fell. You picked yourself up and tried again. You were willing to fail over and over and over, and that is why you're succeeding. You succeeded. How do I know this? You're standing in front of me today." I had tried and I had failed. Now he was asking me to try again. What good would that do? I had already proven I couldn't do it. But if I was honest, I wanted to believe I could. So even though I was worried that I wasn't good enough, I decided to try again. I worked, and then I worked some more. And while I could see I was a little better, it still wasn't all that I had wanted it to be. I stormed up to the sculptor. "See, I told you I wasn't any good, and this proves it. Are you happy now?" "Yes," he replied. "I'm happy. It's good to see you sculpting. But it's terrible. I don't even know what I'm making anymore." "You're making progress," he explained. "I see talents emerging. I see risks being taken. I see courage. I see caring. I see perseverance. Yes, I see much progress indeed. And I hope that you will keep trying." I tried again and again and again. As I stepped back, I looked at my work. I had to admit, I wished I was better. I went to talk to the sculptor, and he asked me to go for a walk with him. He said, "I know it can be hard when things don't turn out the way that you had hoped, but be proud of your failures. I know I am, every one of them." "I can't imagine you ever failing." He laughed, "More times than I can count. But each time you fail, you get a little smarter, a little braver, a little stronger. The truth is, we're all failures. The dreamers, the doers, the creators. Being a failure means you love something, you cared. It means you stepped forward, you didn't hold back, you tried. That is why I brought you here," he gestured to the statues around him. "These are my friends, these are my failures, and I'm grateful for every one of them because they helped me become who I am today. I will tell you a secret," the sculptor confided. "I am now much closer to the end of my life than the beginning, and as time passes, whether we have the courage to do something good and worthwhile or we don't. It's been years since he's been gone, and I will always treasure the time I spent with him, and I will never forget our conversations or what he taught me. When we make it safe to fail, we make it safe to succeed." "How do I do that?" says a young girl. While the metaphor is about a sculptor and his apprentice, I feel that it applies to life in general, and I hope you enjoyed. Thank you. Good evening.
Can we get another round of applause for the class of 2022? Come on, let's go. They're all going, "This is the nicest Mr. Gregory's ever been to me." We're not there yet. So, this is a first for GAAQ, so I'm very happy to do this, okay? I'm skipping ahead. Please welcome Lavinia Lopez and Mia Cecil, who will be performing.
First ever historian. Voted by her peers, she has been part of GEM's American Academy since its founding back in 2014. And I'm so proud of the person she has become. She will be making a speech recalling fond memories of the class of 2022. How appropriate to have a historian who has been here every step of the way. Please welcome Noor Qasim to the stage.
Of people, okay. Fellow esteemed guests and honorable graduates, I'm Noor Qasim, but please call me Nuri, and I'm this year's class historian. We are graduating, can you imagine? First, let's get this straight. This has been probably the most terrifying moment of my life. Actually, the second most terrifying. Trying to walk down those heels was impossible, but writing this speech was a mixed feeling situation. You might think this is a sad, long-going speech, but I'm here to crack you up and give you an insight into our memory line. Being in this school since it opened has been such an honor, but please, I need an award for staying that long. But nonetheless, I cannot be happier that I got to spend those years with all my classmates. It has been a long 8 years in the school. Can't believe that I spent 8 years in the same building, eating the same cafeteria food, but it's okay. I rate their salads 9 out of 10. But listening to Mr. Gregory screaming in the halls, I will definitely miss this man's voice for sure. Our last cap and gown was the moment when we graduated from lower school to middle school and said goodbye to childhood. But now graduating high school to the unknown was goodbye to Google Classroom and final goodbye to Y equal MX plus B. Oh, and final goodbye to please tuck in your shirt. I remember asking Ms. Claire, my fifth grade teacher, if middle school would be different, but it was really another version of Mean Girls. From having banana wars with Mr. Brochard to dancing with Panini on UN Day, and of course, I can't forget to mention Addie's dance moves. To almost getting a concussion like our friend Vasco here in the camping trip, to scream to screaming our lungs out and dancing to the announcement of quarantine in the halls, and to the endless fights with the Arabic department. Also, shout out to Aziz and Dima's iconic club that has scarred the rest of us. And we'll miss Samir begging teachers for extra grades, and to Miss Ali Froggy Moves and her endless love and support for all of us. Not to mention, we went from listening to What the Fox Say to WAP, which of course presents for Women Are Pretty, to the countless times when I tried to pause the Zoom classes or wish to find the answers on a Quizlet. It has been a journey that has brought all of us closer and closer, to the point where I keep seeing hallucinations of all my teachers in my own room. In a way, I'm relieved. I'm relieved that I don't need to hide my non-existent tie under my jacket to escape Mr. Gregory's scan for uniforms in the morning, or having to sneak in the elevators to go upstairs, or from running from Mr. Tyler so he doesn't post us on Instagram. However, I'll miss seeing Mr. Marcus standing outside to greet us in the morning, and Miss Ali feeding us donuts and crackers throughout the year, and will definitely miss being in her advisory, and yes, Ruby back then was the best. No discussions. Looking back this year, I'm sure we got asked this question more than we got asked about our day, and it was, where are you going to university, or what are you gonna do after university? And trust me when I say this, it was the most frustrating question of all time. Like, man, please, I don't even know what I wanna do in the weekends yet. And I remember trying to escape Ms. Thomas's meeting to avoid this question and filling out the numbers of forms she'd haunt us to do. But here we all are, waiting with our caps and gowns, waiting to receive that diploma and chase our dream. Lastly, I would like to thank my parents and dedicate my success and my achievement to them. My parents were the backbone of all. They supported me endlessly and have always provided me with love and kindness. They have shaped me into who I am today, and I cannot be more grateful. After today, we're all going separate direction and separate worlds. However, we won't forget the times we smiled, cried, sang, and danced together. After countless of sleepless nights, dosing on caffeine, staying up on TikTok, and asking for extensions, here we are, class of 2022, about to feel like Kardashians receiving that diploma. Thank you.
Pause. One more time, round of applause for Noor Kasim, our class historian of 2022. I feel like I'm just going to get sick all night, but I hope that's not the case. Thank you, Noor. That was lovely. Our next speaker has been here not as long as Noor, but close, 2015. She has embodied the values of our school through her involvement in various aspects of life at GAAQ, from sports teams, the student council, etc., etc. Through her drive for academic excellence and dedication, she has achieved the ranking of salutatorian. Please welcome Kayla Longland.
All right, stand there and wait for her. Okay. Good evening to all the faculty, parents, friends, family, and most importantly, the class of 2022. I thank God for bringing us all here tonight, and may He bless us on this special occasion. I am Kayla Longland, and it is my honor to present this salutatory speech. I would like to start by congratulating each and every one of you. This accomplishment was not easy, however, we survived, and we made it to the end. To start off, our high school experience took a different turn than what we expected. We expected UN days, spring fairs, no social media nights, house challenges, and sport tournaments. But instead, we got Zoom classes, Zoom assemblies, and attempted virtual events. However, this year, we had fewer restrictions, and we made the most of it. The best way to describe it is like a full circle moment. We started grade 9 as freshmen, excited about our high school journey ahead of us. Then grade 10 happens, and halfway through the year, all of that excitement transformed into fear. The pandemic took control of our lives and forced us to adopt a new way of living. During grade 11, we were in and out of lockdown. Then finally, in grade 12, it started with a few lockdowns, but ultimately, thank God, everything is very close to being normal now. And I'm so grateful that we get to have a proper graduation ceremony, and I believe this is our happy ending to our eventful high school experience. Our high school experience is not defined by the obstacles we faced, but it's defined by the wonderful people who we surrounded ourselves with daily. It's defined by Mr. Miller's distinct laugh, Ms. Cobos's exciting and uplifting energy, Mr. Hatoum's daily jokes, Ms. Bilby's calming character, Ali and Shahad always making everyone laugh, Yahya and Kareem's volleyball obsession, and my English class gossiping group, Adi, Natanya, Orjuan, and Aya. I will dearly miss those times. We can all agree that as a class, we have our differences. However, despite these differences, we bonded. We bonded over our constant complaining whenever the senior room closed down or whenever Kareem hit out the light with the volleyball, falling asleep during Zoom calls and having to call each other to wake up. We bonded at the boat trip where we waited forever for Lean and Orjuan to show up, but it's fine, we know Lean is always late. Oh, and those senior breakfast pancakes were the best, so thank you, juniors. Let's not forget the delicious UN Day food. Shout out to all the moms for always coming through on UN Day. I also want to give a special shout out to all the students who have been here with me since grade 6. I will never forget the banana wars, the laughing and hand slapping game, all those elective classes we had to take like board games and cinematography. 6B, you guys have a special place in my heart. Next, I would like to thank a few people. Thank you to my brother Thomas for being my best friend and always choosing my side. Thank you to my parents for bringing me to this country and school and providing me with plenty of opportunities to flourish. Mama, you are my true inspiration when it comes to everything. You showed me that hard work and dedication can get me anywhere. Papa, thank you for always being so supportive and always offering help whenever needed. Nana, you're the reason why I came to school every morning. And thank you so much for always being my number one supporter. I'm the first to go to university in my family, and I promise to always make you guys proud. Thank you, Ms. Ali and Mr. Gregory, for everything you have ever done for me and my grade. Mr. Gregory, from being my advisory teacher in grade 6, to my math teacher in grade 9, and now my principal in grade 12, I will never forget you. Ms. Ali, where do I even begin? You are the reason why I am such a dedicated student. You taught me how to be a leader and so much more. I would not be where I am today without both of you. Mr. Lenz, thank you for creating such an uplifting and inspiring school environment. This environment nurtured our growth as individuals and as a class. Lastly, thank you to the graduation committee, Ms. LaRue, Ms. Bielby, Ms. Ali, and Mr. Castleberry for making this night possible. Finally, tonight's graduation is more than just celebrating leaving high school. It is celebrating the obstacles we overcame, our tenacity, our hard work, and our ability to adapt to any given circumstance. These characteristics are what describes the class of 2022. As we close this chapter and begin writing a new one, with our dedication, we can accomplish anything we set our minds to. Thank you and enjoy the rest of your evening.
One more time, Kayla Longland, our class salutatorian of 2022. Yours, not mine. You earned it. I wish I could speak that well. They're starting to show me up now. Thank you, Kayla. The next speaker has also been with us since 2015. He has always looked for ways to be creative. He's represented GAAQ on the stage, court, and field. He has achieved the highest academic honor. Wait for it. May I present to you our valedictorian for the class of 2022, Aditya Nair.
You know, I promised myself I wouldn't cry during the speech. Let's see if I can hold that promise. Parents, teachers, friends, distinguished guests, and staff. Good evening, one and all. And of course, to the class of 2022. We are finally here. We are finally done with high school. It was many years of hard work and dedication, and let me congratulate you on your achievement. We worked through a pandemic, fending our way through immeasurable obstacles. There were many uncertainties and new experiences. We hopped onto Zoom straight from bed, trying to brush our teeth while Mr. Cox talked about World War I. We tried to stay awake while Mr. Marley talked about molecular bonds. And friends, don't even try and lie. We all faked those quarantine workouts. Instead of push-ups and pull-ups, we were snacking on chips and pizzas, really improving that quarantine body. Mr. Guy, I don't know where you are, but sorry for the newsflash. On a serious note, that transition from in-person to online school was new to us. Most of us had to deal with a few months of quarantine. Some of us, an entire year. But we persevered. This senior class endured a time where uncertainty was a commonality. And to see us all graduating here today is a testament to that perseverance. Winning valedictorian is a huge honor for me. It truly took a lot of effort. However, I would not be standing here today without the support and encouragement from many. First, I want to thank my parents for having absolutely unrealistic expectations for me. Obviously, I'm joking. I have to go home today. But to be frank, all they expected of me was to put my best foot forward into whatever I do. Acha and Amma, without your support, my accomplishments would not be a reality. And I'm sure this is true for all of us. Let's thank our parents and give them a huge round of applause for their love and support. And of course, how can I forget? To my little brother, Adarsh. Thank you for eating all the brownies and ice cream. It kept me healthy and made sure I was studying instead of devouring snacks. Yes, our siblings may be annoying, but they help us in many ways we don't realize. So a quick round of applause for our siblings. Our head of school, Mr. Mark Lentz, has created a caring and connecting GAAQ community. Thank you, Mr. Lentz, for establishing an enriching and supportive learning environment. Believe me, there are schools where students are scared of their principals and teachers. But even with our scary, formidable, and frightening principal, Mr. Gregory, I know I can walk up to him and say, "What's up, sir?" and not be scared of getting yelled at. Well, it depends on the day. Thank you, Mr. Gregory, for being who you are. Teachers, without you, this day would not have been possible. In fact, this school and our experiences would not have been the same without you enlightening us, encouraging us, and motivating us. You enlightened us through debates and discussions, encouraged us to think for ourselves through current event reports, and motivated us to crack that math problem that we thought we couldn't solve. You truly made our classrooms more vibrant and energetic. So on behalf of the class of 2022, I would like to extend my gratitude to the teachers, senior staff, administrators, and support staff of GEMS AAQ for your endless support and encouragement. Through the years, my friends are the ones who have grounded me. They taught me how to have a balance between academics and having fun. They made me whole. Every day seems brighter when we are around our friends. I have a very special friend here today who flew in from the United States to attend this graduation. Steven is like my older brother who's always looked out for me. I truly appreciate him being here today. Each of our friends connect with us in a unique way. My best friend, Sid, stayed up to listen to my rants at 3 in the morning. Tarun and Sebastian were always there for me. Ali and Kareem, you always made me laugh whenever I needed a break. Kayla and Naina, I'll never forget our endless gossip sessions. Dima and Yahya, you were always the most fun and enjoyable to be around. I'm so proud to call you my friends and so proud of the people you've become. Thank you for always being there for me, no matter how down I was. To the class of 2022, I'm sure all of you have friends who cared for you, stood for you, and believed in you. Make sure to tell them how much you appreciate and love them. So once again, the class of 2022, we are finally here. We are finally done with high school. Our teachers, parents, and friends have prepared us for today and beyond. Despite setbacks, we showed unrelenting perseverance. Today, after years of working through adversity, we have achieved something great. While there will be uncertainties in the future, we will persevere, we will excel, and we will succeed. As I stand before you today, I feel excited and privileged. Excited by the amount of talent I see in the GAAQ class of 2022, and privileged to be one among you. I truly can't wait to see what we will accomplish. So the seniors of GAAQ, the class of 2022, let us mold the future together. Thank you.
Stand there. Come on, you can do better than that. Let's go. So, another performance. Are they ready? I hope they're ready. Okay. Okay, while you're over there, class of 2022, could we do a selfie? If I come over. So, when they're ready, let's do a round of applause first, but please welcome our second musical performance with the vocals by Nain and Nair.
Thank you.
So, the next part we've never done before. So we've got loads of new things this time. I'm so happy. Always improving. So we've got some special awards, which are going to be a surprise to some students. So guys, if you hear your name, just try to make your way up the stage, okay? Miss Thomas is going to introduce and bring our staff up, who we're going to be introducing.
Thank you so much. So now we're going to present the special awards. The first special award is the Unsung Hero Award, which will be presented by Mr. Cox.
Unsung Hero Award might just be my favorite award on the list at this year's graduation. It is awarded to one grade 12 student who performed great deeds but received little or no recognition for them. The student who was selected as this year's winner is one that is more likely to run towards a challenge rather than away from it, and does so with a positive attitude that is absolutely contagious. This quality stood out to the members of the faculty. We believe the student is deserving of the award because they are caring, collaborative, and perfectly embody GAAQ's core values: respect, purpose, innovation, tenacity, and leadership. To put it simply, they are the heart of this year's cohort of graduates. So without further ado, the winner of the Unsung Hero Award for the class of 2022 is Maria Eduarda Dutra Niederberger.
Thank you so much, Mr. Cox, and congratulations, Maria. We will now have the Community Service Award presented by Ms. Ali.
Hi. I am presenting the Community Service Award. This award is for a 12th grade student who has shown an outstanding contribution both locally as well as within our school community. I'm really happy to be providing this award to this student. She has shown so much, Okay. The 12th grade student that is receiving the Community Service Award is Asilatul Fatima.
Thank you so much, Ms. Ali, and congratulations, Asilatul. We will now have the Athletics Award presented by Mr. Gadd.
Hello, I'm Mr. Gadd, and I'll be presenting the Athletics Award. When I look over at this group of graduates, I see so many tremendous athletes. A group of gifted leaders, and most importantly, some amazing young adults. Picking the athlete of the year wasn't easy, and Ms. Thomas knows how many times I went back and forth with her over it. Ultimately, I picked this student not only because of their incredible natural athleticism and ability, but also due to their growth as a leader and the sportsmanship and kindness that they have shown on and off the field of play. They also were the student that absolutely destroyed me on the badminton court. The award goes to Uriel Afori Atta. I'm also sure he did his online workouts as well.
Thank you so much, Mr. Gad, and congratulations, Uriel. We'll now present the World Language Distinguished Scholar Award. There are three winners for this award. We will first call Ms. Cobos from the Spanish division.
Hi, good evening. This award is given to a student that is committed to learning a language, a foreign language, and for his or her dedication to it. This year's Spanish award goes to a lady that has been in my class for 5 years. During this time, she has achieved proficiency in the language. She has presented the AP Spanish Language and Culture exam, obtaining the best possible grade. She has presented the AP Literature and Culture exam, obtaining the best possible grade. She has been a writer and contributor and editor in El Periódico, a Spanish publication that we have for our community. And she decided to apply to a university in Spain, and she was accepted to a degree in genetics that is exclusively taught in Spanish. I couldn't be prouder for her motivation, dedication, and effort. Jasmine Negreiros, this award is yours.
Thank you so much, Ms. Covers, and congratulations, Yasmin. We'll now have the Arabic division, and this will be presented by Mr. Hassan.
And finally, in Arabic, assalamu alaikum. جائزة التميز في اللغة العربية تمنح لأكثر الطلاب اجتهاداً وتفوقاً في اللغة العربية من حيث التحصيل الأكاديمي وبالأخص من حيث تمثل روح الأصالة التي تفيض بها هذه اللغة الخالدة. في الحقيقة لم يكن الاختيار سهلاً، فلقد شرفت بتدريس هذه المجموعة من الطلاب، حيث رأيت أن السعي إلى الاجتهاد والتفوق سمة لكل واحد منهم، ولكنني في النهاية متأكد من أن هذه الجائزة ستذهب إلى أفضل مستحقيها. إنها الطالبة التي اعتادت مذاق التفوق وجعلت الاجتهاد طريقاً لا محيد عنه. لطالما أحبت اللغة العربية وتمثلت روحها الوثابة. إنها طالبتي الرائعة المتألقة مريم سعيد.
Thank you so much, Mr. Hassan, and congratulations, Miriam. We will now have the French division presented by Ms. Dorsef.
Hello, everyone. First thing, I want to tell all my French students that you did an amazing job during the years that I taught you. It's not only about having excellent grades, but the most important was about your behavior, your understanding, and your lovely words. For this award, it was really hard for me to choose just one student, and I was I was even negotiating with Miss Nikisha to just like choose two students, four students, but like it was, we have to choose just one. So I choose this student for the dedication of that he had over the years for the French. The first time that he came to my class, he did not know anything in French, but the tenacity and all the good behavior that I saw on him during the years, it's remarkable. So this award goes to the amazing Muhammad Riyas Hidayat.
Thank you so much, Ms. Dorsaf, and congratulations, Mohammed. We will now have the Creativity Award. In this section, there are four awards. We'll first present the Music Award by Mr. Casaberry.
Good evening. I don't do prepared remarks, mostly because I write them down and then I put them somewhere safe and then I lose them. So I'm like all the other teachers here that have these awards. I got stuck between 17, 18 students to choose from, and it's really hard, especially as a music teacher in GEMS. We work with so many amazing musicians that it's hard to choose one. So I had to go beyond the musical aspect to find the candidate for this position. So I was lucky enough to teach this student for 3 years. The first year as a study hall. And I know what you're thinking. You're a music teacher. How are you going to teach this kid music in study hall? It was amazing to see this young person come into study hall, finish all the work, and then, sir, can I go over to the piano lab and practice? Yeah, you can ask a music teacher if you can practice. Yes, please, you can go practice. And the sound that came out of the room was like the angels singing and the light shines down. And then the next year, I got to actually teach this person as a musician. And it was amazing again. And then COVID. So all those concerts that we had to do virtually were still amazing, but they would have been so much better in person. And then this year, I got to see this person grow from being merely a single instrumental player to a vocalist and most recently a drummer. I want to say a personal thank you for this person allowing me to be the teacher that I needed to be for her. Kamsahamnida, Wampyuke, Sionbek.
Thank you so much, Mr. Casaberry, and congratulations, Sion. We're now going to have band presented by Miss Leach.
Thank you. The Creativity Award for Band is for a student that demonstrates exceptional efforts to learn new things, develop new skills and competencies, and expand their creative talent through music and the arts. This student is a leader in both in music and in band, and has a true passion for the arts. This student has taken band at GAAQ for the past 7 years and played both the trumpet and the French horn. Outside of band, this student expanded her knowledge in the AP Music Theory course and has actively participated with the GAAQ Modern Music Ensembles and the Qatar Youth Choir. She creates her own original music and plans to attend university to study songwriting and performance. For the past 2 years, I have truly been inspired by her passion for music, and I am so excited to see how she cultivates her talents at university and beyond. You all heard tonight she has the most stunning voice. I am proud to present the Creativity Award for Band to Miss Naina Nair.
Thank you so much, Ms. Leach, and congratulations, Naina. We'll now have Ms. LaRue, who will present the Performing Arts Award as well as the Visual Arts Award. Unfortunately, Ms. Tracy was not able to be with us today.
Good evening again. Unfortunately, Ms. Tracy has had a really rough week, so when she asked me to say something on behalf of her, I knew it was going to be a very... Oh, sorry, I forgot my mask. Knowing the winner, it made it really easy for me to actually talk on her behalf, because I have not had more conversations with a teacher about another student as I have with Ms. Tracy about this winner. It's so easy to say, yeah, that's what I wrote here. For years, she has sung his praises consistently. She describes him as outstanding, brave, inspiring, and exceptional. She wants you to know how proud she is of you and wants to thank you for being an exceptional student and, more importantly, an exceptional human being. The Creativity Award for Performing Arts this year, 2022, goes to Rohit Lal. Then once again, this student has helped me stay on top of my game as a teacher since day one at GAAQ. Without the support of the student actually being so incredibly motivated to pursue visual arts, practicing on their own, developing new skills on their own, and then making suggestions. Because as a young teacher, although I had the skill, I wasn't always clued up as to what sixth graders needed to learn about. Or what movies they wanted to watch on the days that we had our parties. I'm so proud of how capable this person has become. And although she was not able to take art in her senior year, she exceeded in every year prior to this. In her junior year, she took AP Visual Arts, and is an exceptionally talented artist. It was a very difficult decision because I had many people who fit this category, in fact, and to not choose a student that took art this year was also really tough. But the Visual Arts Award goes to Lavinia Cardia Lopez.
We will now have Ms. Liu present again the GEMS GAAQ Flagship Award.
All right, this is an award for some of our founding students at GAAQ. This is the first year that we've been able to do this. As the year that we opened in 2014, school was open and from pre-K until grade 5 only. So the following students were here in grade 5. Life as an expat can be very unpredictable, I'm sure as you all know. But these students have been at GAAQ for 8 years, making them our first flagship graduates. Congratulations, and thank you and your parents for your unwavering support since day one. Well done to Naina Nair. Sorry. Noor Qasim. And lastly, Cesar Marcano.
Okay, last but not least, we will now have Mr. Miller present the Poet Laureate and the Group Poem Laureates.
Thank you, good evening. Ladies and gentlemen, once upon a time, a poem saved the world. It was only 3 lines. Love, I believe. Love, don't forget me. And love, I'm sorry. And so the world was saved, and the sun rose, and the day began again anew. This was the first year GEMS had a slam, a poetry slam, and the first place poet laureate winner of the competition from the class of 2022 for the individual poem is none other than Mr. Adita Nair. There was also a competition for best group poem, and the group that took the first place, group poet laureates, are none other than the Wordbenders, represented again by Mr. Adita Nair, Orjuan Milham. Miss Kayla Longland. Miss Aya Bellew. And last but not least, Miss Natania Vino. Ladies and gentlemen, a round of applause. Thank you.
And that ends our special awards. Thank you.
Okay, one more time, a round of applause for all of our award winners. Thank you to all the staff that had a speech. We will now have the third and final performance with vocals by our very own Nada Uri singing Skyfall. time for Steamgate, our grade 11 and younger, and Nada. What can I say, class of 2022? You've made me laugh, you've made me cry, and I mean cry. I've been in class and I've cried. I'm not afraid to admit that. You've made me mad and shout, but most importantly, throughout this whole year and tonight, you've made me proud. I am so happy to stand here today and celebrate this moment with you. You will always hold a special place in our hearts and mine. You are the first graduating class to have been here since our opening in 2014. I feel honored to have been here for the last 7 years and watch you all grow into the compassionate and thoughtful young adults you've become. I've been your teacher, I've been your principal, I've been your assistant principal, I've been your acting principal, I've been your department head, I could go on, but I've also been your friend. And nothing makes me prouder than to stand up here and watch you cross this stage today. I will not cry, maybe a little bit, we'll see. I made a mistake earlier in the year. I stated that this year's group would be our first graduating group who made it all through middle and high school. Although that statement is true, I completely forgot about the fact that Nana, Nora, and Caesar were here with us in grade 5, making them the first students to graduate having attended elementary, middle, and high school. You've all made tremendous contributions to the school community. You've left imprints and a high standard for future students to fulfill. Grade 11 students, pay attention, the ones that are here. As you cross the stage today, there is no doubt in my mind that you are all ready for the challenges and opportunities you will face in the next chapter of your lives. I will cherish every memory that I've made with each of you over the years. Whether it was in Sri Lanka on our first ever international trip with only, I think, 8 students, and I was the only one going at 25 years of age, very scary. Or skiing in Georgia, where I fell many times and they laughed at me, especially the one time I fell off the ski lift. That is very embarrassing, yes. Or coaching and being very passionate with the under 19 or under 16 football team. There's only a few of you left. I have taught some of you Islamic art. I have taught some of you geometry. I have taught some of you AP calculus, regular calculus. I have taught some of you Greek mythology at one stage, I believe, many years ago. But I hope I have been more to you than a teacher and a mentor. I get told that I wear my emotions on my face, usually angry. You guys have seen me struggle over the years. You've seen me struggle this week. Hopefully not tonight. I think I'm doing okay. But I'm happy that I haven't hidden that struggle from you. Because that is life. It will be a struggle at times, but it is moments like tonight that make that struggle worth every moment. I remember the last time I stood in this venue, 3 years ago as an assistant principal under the principal at the time, Miss Tiffany. It was our first graduating group, and we were very proud as a school, even though we had so much to learn. At the time, we only had 34 seniors. We discussed that night how we would improve this for next year, what little tweaks we would make to build on this legacy and celebration, but unfortunately we never got the chance. For me to now stand here again as the principal, live, with staff, with parents, and with students, gives me hope for the future. It has been difficult these past years, and I hope tonight, as graduates, you give a moment of thanks to your teacher, student, and parents for the support they have provided over these years. For those students who have been with us for a long period of time, I hope you can acknowledge the growth that has happened within the school and take ownership of that change. Those changes have been empowered by your voice. I cannot wait to see the impact you will all make on our world. I speak to you no longer as my students, but as young adults. If there is one piece of advice I can leave with you today, it is continue to be your true self. Be compassionate, be tenacious, be purposeful, be respectful, and be the leaders I know you're all meant to be. As you continue down your path, remember to be optimistic and to appreciate the world around you. The pandemic will not only be the only challenge you face in your life. So as you move on, remember to embrace the challenges and appreciate the learning experience that come with each day. Congratulations, class of 2022. Make us proud, and remember you are GAAQ. Jeff, you ready? We will now be presenting the diplomas. By the power vested in me, by the State of Qatar's Ministry of Education, GEMS Education, and by the virtue of certification made by your head of school, Mr. Mark Lentz, you have satisfactorily completed all of the requirements of the American curriculum in Qatar, and I hereby confirm your graduation this day, June 2nd, 2022, at GEMS American Academy. Mr. Wessel will call out the names as we award the certificates.
Adham Alhaj Hussein. Reem Abusada. Abdulrahman Afifi Abdulmajid. Laura Aker. Almuthana Al-Sabehi. Sud Al-Tamimi. Mohammed Ahmed Alam. Yahya Ali. Abdulaziz Al-Kharji. Ali Al-Jalfi. Al-Hanouf Al-Madid. Al-Jazi Al-Madid. Lean Al-Khattab. Hussein Al-Saig. Dima Al-Sulaiti. Reem Al-Sulaiti. Mohammed Al-Falatini. Rami Al-Zabet. Mazen Amar. Diego Arenza. Mohammed Bakush. Sion Bak. Aya Yasmin Baloum. Zaid Ben Signy. Rehan Chirukutu. Mia Sissel. Sanjay Dakshin. Gabriel Diaz. Laura Dore. Lean El Hamoud. Ahmad Fadi. Vasco Feijó. Ala Gafar. Gisela Hapsari. Aza Harris. Riyas Hidayat. Ala Hussein. Samir Jarudi. Hisham Jawahar. Kasim. Shad Khalaf. Kareem Khalil. Sami Khalil. Anna Kiss. Nicholas Lavara. Laura Ledmeyer. Lavinia Lopez. Malik. Cesar Daniel Marcano Tuneo. Sebastian Marquez. Naina Nair. Ofori Atta. Nada Ori. Firas Kidwai. Maryam Saeed. Asilathul Fatima Sheikh Abdallah. The following students are graduating with high honors. Ibrahim Adawiya. Amina Isagali. Ojuan Melham. Natania Vinel. Yep. Yasmin Negreros. Omar Youssef.
Love you, Omar.
The following students are graduating with distinguished honors. Ahad Abu Ghosa. Dima Al Farhan. Zaina Bahlul. Kayla Longland. The following students are graduating with the AP Capstone Diploma, which is an enormous feat. AP Capstone candidates have completed 6 AP courses, including AP seminar and research, with passing exam scores. Fahim Yasser. Capstone Diploma and High Honors, Maria Eduarda Dutra Niederberger. With the Capstone Diploma and also High Honors, Rohit Aaron Lal. With the AP Capstone Diploma and Distinguished Honors, our valedictorian, Mr. Aditya Nair.
One more time for the class of 2022. It's definitely not the last time. Oh, well, let's keep it going. So I just want to do a few final thank yous, and then we have three lovely ladies who are going to come up and thank some special people. Please remember as you leave today to thank Mr. Lentz, our head of school. Without any of this, wouldn't be here if it wasn't for him, okay? He's the one that signs off and makes sure that we get what we want when we ask. Thank you, Mr. Lentz. Miss LaRue, who has worked tirelessly to get the best graduation we could have under this current circumstance. She has worked around the clock to make this day special for you, and it has not been easy. This is a hard year to plan an event like this, okay? So well done, Miss LaRue. Mr. Tyler, our parent relations executive, who's also been a great help. Mr. Castleberry for the music, although he didn't perform, but Miss Thomas for all the help of making these students get into the third level of education. To our faculty team. To our faculty team who've been working in the background, and finally to all of your teachers who have worked so hard to help you prepare for college and university and the world beyond. I would like to take this opportunity to have Kayla, Orjuan, and Asilatul to come to stage for a final thank you to several members of the key staff. Thank you.
Sorry. Hello again. Before the night ends, I would like to thank a special teacher. This teacher is like my second mother, and I know many of the students here feel the same way. Without her, our high school journey would be very different. She has the purest and kindest soul. She's always there whenever we need her, and she has the ability to light up every room she walks in. I could talk about her for ages. Miss Ali, we will all miss you dearly. And wish you the best on your new journey.
I'm Asila, and I'm here to introduce another amazing person who is not a teacher, but is still special to us. She supported us during our difficult times, both socially and emotionally. She made sure that she was always there for us. She's a very sweet person, but also just a little annoying when it comes to university applications. But we still love her no matter what she does. She knows that very well. It's my pleasure to call our high school counselor, Ms. Nikisha Thomas, on stage to collect a small gift.
Hello everyone, I'm Orjuan, and last but not least, I would like to take a moment to thank one more very special teacher. This teacher has been with the class of 2022 since the very beginning and has constantly supported all of us in many ways over the past few years. She has worked tirelessly planning this graduation and ensuring that we all have the best night possible celebrating our class. She's also a teacher that has had a great influence on me personally and many other art students over the past 7 years by teaching us all how to express ourselves creatively and use our artistic talents to the best of our ability. Ms. LaRue, thank you for everything you have done for us. You are truly a phenomenal teacher.
We're nearly there. Are we ready? Okay, one last second. Sure, we don't want to wait a little longer. No, we ready? Parents, are we ready? No? No. Okay. I now present to you GAAQ's graduating class of 2022. Turn tassel, go Raptors!
Hi everyone, one last thing. The flowers and the balloons do need to be taken from the venue, so you are welcome to help yourselves to some flowers and balloons if you want to take them to keep on celebrating in your house. Have a lovely evening.